Today, I wanted to talk a little bit about Google Photos. I've been the kind of person who fell in love with Google Photos a long time ago. When it first launched, I was just super impressed with this concept that you could store as many photos and videos as you want. The only thing you have to think about is that everything becomes slightly compressed. So if you're shooting in 4K, it will turn your videos into 1080p videos. If you take very big photos, it will compress the photos. And most of the time, I felt like it was a fair compromise to get unlimited storage for free. This service was so good that I was sure that Google was up to something no good, you know? It felt like too good to be true. Instead of storing all of my pictures and videos on clunky old hard drives or expensive cloud storage solutions, I happily embraced Google Photos and I got all my friends and family members to get Google Photos. And then a couple of weeks ago, Google came out with the big news that they are no longer going to be able to offer people unlimited storage. And this is the moment where Google just broke my heart. But it taught me a very valuable lesson. And that's what I wanted to talk about today. So you can still store unlimited storage on Google Photos until I think something like summer 2021, which is great. You have some time left, but you sort of have to figure out what you're gonna do at that point. First of all, let me just say, Google, if you're listening, like, I get it. You thought you had a product and you could somehow use it in order to track people or something, but you realized that you probably couldn't, you weren't allowed to. And so you were paying for a lot of storage all over the world and this service was costing you money. I get that. The problem, and this is the shady part of this whole story, is that a lot of people who have basically invested, like, we never paid for anything. Like, I get that part, but we sort of gave up image quality to get this unlimited storage solution. And now when you're taking it back and we have to find a different solution, it sort of feels like it's too late. We've ruined our pictures. And Google has been very clever here. Like, they've said that you can still have this unlimited storage. You just can't fill it up anymore without paying for it. This is the part that gets me, because we're using this service and in order to keep using it, we're gonna probably have to pay more for it. So this is the shady part. It feels like they sort of tricked me into getting this product for free and now I have to keep using it. First of all, let me just say, Google, I'm not doing it. You know, I'm taking back my photos. I'm gonna get back to storing them on my hard drive. And I'm gonna talk to you guys about why. So I'm a huge fan of this whole cloud storage solution thing until this thing happened, because it taught me a very valuable lesson. Everything that is digital, every service out there is beyond your control. And this is the perfect example. Google Photos was a fantastic service. It still is, but it's not going to be in the summer of 2021. After that, I think that a lot of people are gonna drop Google Photos like a bad habit. Sorry, Google, but it's the truth. Like, people are gonna go back to Apple iCloud. They're gonna go to the OneDrive on Microsoft. And some people will probably be using Google Drive. That's like a different thing, Google Drive. It's a service that I do use. I really like that. It works tremendously well. But all of these storage solutions, like, I'm just thinking in the back of my head, like, this reminds me how little control we have over it. Like, the other day, all the channels on our TV just disappeared. You know, we had no access to it for a couple of hours. Like, this affected like 400,000 people here in Sweden. And it's because the control over the content lies someplace else. And so I'm thinking to myself, if you have important information, if you have pictures and videos, things that are very important to you, if you want complete control over it, you can't store it digitally. Like, you can use it like a backup solution. That's where I think that a cloud service is very good. It's a very good backup situation. But if we're talking about control over your content, then I think that hard drives is the best way to go, which feels kind of backwards. I know, I get it, but it just feels like this digital cloud storage solution, it has flaws, you know? Like, I feel kind of old saying this. No, it's safer to keep things on hard drives. drives. I know how it sounds. Like, I can hear the words coming out of my mouth and I'm thinking to myself, you sound like an old guy. But it's the truth. Like, newer doesn't always mean better. It just means better at some things, but worse at other things. It sort of reminds me of, I don't know if you heard, but in the last like 10 years, Hollywood has basically been shifting from analog cameras to digital cameras. There are still some directors out there, like Christopher Nolan, who still prefer analog. And the digital offers a lot, you know? It's better image quality, there is no noise, and you can edit it much easier than when you have to have like these film rolls from analog film cameras. Like, it's very messy. But the upside of film is that it lasts forever. It's a good example of how an older technology is still superior to newer technology. And with this Google Photos thing, I'm thinking to myself that cloud storage solutions, fantastic for backup, but not very reliable, because you never know if prices change, people will hack them, something like that. You just never know. I think that this year I'm going to be looking into better storage solutions, because right now I do have a couple of SSD drives, USB flash drives, but I'm thinking that maybe I should have something like a dual system, you know, in case one drive fails, you have a backup drive, something like that. But as a minimalist also, I don't like to store that much, you know? So this is actually a very common discussion that I have with my wife. Like, what am I gonna do with all my photos, my video files, my raw videos while I'm shooting this film? Like, there have been moments where I've deleted video files and then I've really, really regretted it, you know? So I'm still working on it. I don't have all the answers, but it's something that I'm still looking into, you know? Anyway, if you have any thoughts about this whole Google Photos thing or how to store photos and videos, let me know in the comment section below. It will be fun to know. And hope you liked this video. And if you did, you know what to do. Take care.